we were walking home after work and we lit up on it and I took a hit. And I wasn't a drinker either. So I was not used to sort of being out of my, you know, sort of left brain problem solving consciousness. But even after that, it wasn't a large part of my life. I was very drug free, drink free, even though I was a rock star. My friends used to say, rock stardom is wasted on you. You know, I didn't, you know, go crazy and throw TVs out the windows or anything.
As a college football player, I won the Heisman Trophy, which goes to the best football player in America. When I left college, I was the all-time NCAA leader in rushing yards and touchdowns and all-purpose yards.
Ricky Williams runs to the Hall of Fame.
Led the NFL in rushing. He's one of the hardest workers. One of the most physical players on the field. One of the most relentless players on the field. After work, we'd come home, go in the back, smoke a little bit, and play video games. It was something that I enjoyed at that point. You know, it kind of felt like I have this stressful job where I'm beating my mind and my body up, and to have something to do when I come home to help me relax, recuperate so I can get ready to go back and do it again the next day.
One of my clients, he got busted doing a major, at the time, marijuana deal, 500 pounds or something like that. When they interviewed him, the government found out that he was a friend of mine and facing 40 years to life or whatever. He calls me and says, I gotta come over. He came in a back door and he brings in two garbage bags, which I didn't see until after. And he put it in one of our back rooms and left. 10 minutes later, the doors came off. 35 guys, ski masks, automatic weapons. I'm on the floor with a 20-something year old kid with a gun to my head screaming at me at the top of his lungs, don't move, motherfucker, I'm gonna blow your head off. I'm looking up at him and I'm saying, calm down. I'm the calm one.